I definitely had those sleepless nights where I would just go online and I would just read and read and read and fear and fear and fear what was to come. You know, the most morbid things you can think of, how does a person, like, I remember searching once, how does a person with brain cancer die? You know, what are the physical symptoms? Just things like that. The darkest possible things. I wanted to be, I don't know what I wanted exactly in all that. It was a compulsion. It was an obsession, really. But at the same time, I think I was seeking information because I was seeking a certain amount of control. I wanted to know anything and everything that I could find about this situation that I was currently in, that I was living. And it wasn't, I feel like it wasn't until the clinical trial with the medical device when I started using it that I was suddenly able to sleep again. Well, better. I was still able to sleep. After a while, you're just so exhausted that you just pass out. But it was very hard to get over that. The radiation too. Radiation just knocks you out. it's not quite a good kind of peaceful kind of sleep. It's more of a, oh my God, my brain was just irradiated kind of sleep. It's the fear around death is something that I don't think anyone gets over or resolved. I feel like I've been able to accept mortality. That's kind of how I like to see it. I accept that death is a part of life. I don't want it. Absolutely, I don't want it. But I feel like I might be better. I'm somewhat prepared for it. That's why a lot. I think doing all this pre end of life stuff is so important. Things like setting up your power of attorney, your wills, things like that. My parents can't wait to inherit all my debt, my student loans. Shh, they're not going to see this, right? it's anything that you can do to prepare others goes a long way. Because really, that's who's going to be left. And for me, it was anything that I could do to control my situation really helped with my anxiety, really helped with my fears, really helped with me kind of even doing any life projects at all, considering the fact that I was going to die soon. I was able to keep working. I was able to do this clinical trial. I was able to maintain a relationship. I was able to maintain good friendships, real friendships, authentic friendships. It's a matter of maintaining a sense of control for me, is what it was. Even just actively participating in your treatment decisions around treatment, just, you know, the smallest things, you know, just asking questions to your oncologist, seeking out more information, seeking out second opinions, professionals, reading research articles. I'm a very active participant, I guess. I became a very active participant, and that was because I wanted to maintain some control. There was a certain amount of desperation in there, sure, but it helped me tremendously with my anxiety, with my fears. Yeah. and with coming to terms with my situation.